All right, tell me what's wrong with the shot. Yep, way too long. This is easily fixed. You just blade it here, then again at the end, speed up the middle part, and just like that, it's fixed. Nope, nope, and nope. That made it look even worse. Today, we're going to take a look at how to properly speed round clips in Final Cut Pro, and the effects you can add to make it look even better. When done properly, speed ramping is an essential tool every editor should have in their toolbox. If you don't know what speed ramping is, it's when you gradually speed up or slow down a clip. The main thing about speeding up or slowing down a clip is you need to make it smooth. In my example at the start, I just bladed my clip and sped up the middle part. That hard cut and a sudden speed change looks plain bad, and the choppy movement in the sped up part of my clip also looks very unnatural. Let's fix all that. First of all, when you need to change the speed of a clip partway through a clip, like in my example, where I went from normal speed to sped up, then back to normal, instead of blading your clip, Final Cut Pro allows you to blade the speed of a clip. There's a couple of advantages to this, I'll show you right away. But first, to blade the speed of your clip, place your playhead on the frame you want to blade your speed, go up to the retime controls at the bottom of the viewer window, and select blade speed. Your clip remains whole, but the speed of your clip is divided into two sections. In my example, I want to slow it back down to the original speed at the end. So I'll place my playhead on the frame where I want the clip to slow back down, and this time use the keyboard shortcut Shift V to blade speed again in my clip. So my clip is now split into three speed segments, but since all three are set to 100%, nothing has changed yet. Now let's open the speed dropdown of our middle segment, select fast, and let's try 20 times the original speed. This speeds up our middle part, then the start and end of our clip stay at the original speed. But instead of the speed of our clip changing abruptly, it gradually transitions from normal speed to 20x. That's what these gray bars are in the retime bar, speed transitions. And they're fully adjustable. Just click and drag these out to make the speed change more gradual, or drag them in towards the middle to make it faster. We also get retime handles at the end of each speed segment. So if we want to speed up our middle even more, we just grab the retime handle at the end of our speed segment and drag it over. Just this alone makes our clip look significantly better, but we can do more. Let's play back the sped up part of our clip. See how choppy it is? Like I said before, the trick to good looking speed ramps is they have to be smooth. Our sped up playback is not smooth at all. There's a lot of fast movement here. So do you know what we're missing? That's right, motion blur. Unfortunately, Final Cut Pro doesn't have a built-in motion blur effect, but today's sponsor, Motion VFX, does. Their M-Film Look plugin, besides having all sorts of tools and effects to make your footage look more cinematic, has recently been updated with a new Motion Blur AI effect. It's super simple to use. It makes speed ramps look so much better. Let's go to our effects browser, select M-Film Look, and add the Motion Blur AI effect to our clip. It's pretty straightforward. Up in the video inspector, we have a few simple controls. First is quality. You have a default setting here, which gives you best quality, or you can choose fast for a quicker render. Under this, we have a method dropdown, where you can choose from simple, you can emulate a specific shutter speed, or even shutter angle if you're going for a realistic look. For our example, let's leave it at the default settings. Look at how much better this looks. You can also keyframe this effect to make it stand out even more. Let's set our playhead at the start of our speed transition, bring the intensity down to zero, and add a keyframe. We'll move our playhead to the end of our first speed segment, and bring the intensity all the way up to 100%. Reverse this at the end. Let's render out our clip and see how much better that looks. Motion Blur AI for Motion VFX is available exclusively as part of CineStudio, a collection of over 20 of Motion VFX's top value products, including M-Tracker 3D, M-Tracker Surface, and a fully remastered M-Film Look. Click the link in the video description and try it free for 14 days. Let's take a look at another example with a more in-depth look and a slightly different way to add speed ramps in Final Cut Pro. For my next clip, I want to start speeding up around here So I'll add a marker to mark this spot. I want to slow it back down close to the end, so I'll add another marker. Next, press R on your keyboard to switch over to your range tool, and click and drag out a range in your clip from one marker to the next. With the range selected, let's head up to the retime menu, and let's try 8x. Final Cut Pro only speeds up our selected range and adds speed transitions at the start and the end. Let's play this back and see how it looks. I think we need to speed this up quite a bit more. Open the Speed drop-down menu in your timeline, select Custom, and let's try 4000%. That's better. Now, if you're bladed your speed in the wrong spot, instead of starting over, Final Cut Pro lets you adjust the frame you bladed on. Move your cursor over the retime handle in your timeline, and double-click the retime bar. A hidden pop-up opens up, where you can turn on or off your speed transitions and edit your source frame. Just click the Edit button and drag the source frame icon to adjust where your clip changes speed. Just like before, let's add some motion blur and render out our clip for this cool speed ramp effect. So far, we've only used speed ramps to speed clips up, but we can also use speed ramps to slow our clips down, even bring them to a complete stop. In our next clip, let's freeze our subject midair. Find the frame where you want to freeze your subject and press Shift-H to add a hold frame there. Let's make it a little bit shorter. Next, switch to the Range Selection tool, skim to the part where you want to start slowing your clip down, and drag out a range from there to your hold frame. Open the Retime drop-down menu and select Speed Ramp and 2-0. Final Cut Pro splits our selected range into four separate speed segments and adds transitions to gradually slow our clip down to zero. We can reverse this on the other side of our hold frame and gradually bring our speed back up. Let's select another range in our timeline after our hold frame, and this time, from a speed dropdown, select Speed Ramp and From Zero. For best quality, select your entire clip, and from the speed dropdown, change the video quality to machine learning. Render out your clip for this cool effect. As you can see, there's a lot of cool things you can do with speed ramping in Final Cut Pro. Just remember, for it to look good, it needs to be smooth. I recommend adding motion blur when speeding clips up, and using smooth slow-mo when slowing them down. And if you need quality motion blur, or just quality plugins in general, check out Motion VFX. I'll link them down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.